Hi. In my first video, I explained how to look at the designed world in terms of what, how, and why. Examining the world this way helps you to see how the three levels are connected. If you practice this more often, you will get a better understanding of why products are the way they are. And you will start to see that they could also have been different, or should be different. Why is that? When you fully understand the context, the set of reasons and considerations underlying existing designs and practices, you cannot avoid thinking things like, but this factor is completely outdated, or the world has changed in so many respects, or there is a new trend in this domain that should be addressed, or they did not consider this human trait that is so interesting to include here. If you have these kind of thoughts, you start to feel a sense of urgency to act. If you have these kinds of thoughts, as I hope you do, you think and feel like a designer, someone who sees opportunities to change the world for the better. If you have these kind of thoughts, you have started to think about a new context, a different set of reasons and considerations that may underlie the new design. By doing this, you have entered the design side of our model, the side where we reason from context via the interaction to the product concept, the side where we reason from why via how to what. This is what designing is all about, and it all sounds so deceptively simple. You will discover that actually doing it is slightly more complicated. Why would that be? First, you have to decide what factors to take into account in your new context. What is the set of reasons and considerations you want to work with? In other words, what will the reason of existence of your design be? What is the effect, the experience, the behavior you want to cause in the lives of people you are designing for? Obviously, these factors can come from many different sources and can be found anywhere. When the factors are mainly found in technology, we speak of a technology push. When the factors are foremost based on market research, research on what people like and do, we speak of a market pull. In the human-centered design process that we advocate, however, the factors stem primarily from understanding people and the world they live in. Let me give an example. When you want or are asked to design a new car, you could consider trends and developments in mobility, such as status is shifting from ownership to relationships. Natural resources like petrol and gas are rapidly running out. Congestion in inner cities is growing. Next to these, you could also consider to include various insights about people that are more fixed. These are human principles, such as people want to communicate everywhere and anytime. People cannot concentrate for more than 20 minutes. Or people like the sensation of danger, but only when they know it is actually safe, like in a roller coaster. These kind of factors can be found anywhere, and you have to do proper research to find the ones you like and need. You can look into the media and on the internet. You can carefully look around and listen to others. You can interview experts and consult scientific studies. And you can go outside and observe people or even talk to them. What is important to realize is that no one will tell you what factors are the ones you have to use. You as a designer, or more likely as a design team, have to decide what factors are relevant and interesting. You have to make the choices, and that makes you responsible for the final design and all its implications. And the implications can be enormous if we only think for a moment about the impact cars, the internet and mobile phones, for example, had and keep on having on our society. This makes designing such a beautiful activity and profession. And this makes designing as responsible as the work of an engineer or a medical doctor. If you still think you can handle this responsibility, I very much invite you to continue next week with module 3 of this course. Here we will visit other people at their homes to investigate how they have shaped their morning ritual. And this type of research may help you to find further reasons for your design. Enjoy and good luck.